First of all, I want to thank His Excellency Uhuru Kenyatta for inviting me for this state visit, which has been very, very, very profitable, very fruitful. We have just started, but we have covered a lot of ground. However, even before this visit, as soon as His Excellency came into government during the last, what we call in Uganda, Kisanja. Kisanja means the term of office, the 5 years, it's the Uganda word. I don't know how they call it in Swahili.
Awami.
Awami. Awamu. Even in the last awamu, straight away he handled our perennial problem of delays in Mombasa. Before his time, some of the people in the port thought they were doing Uganda a favor by handling our goods. So you had to come and beg them, please, tafadhali, in Swahili. Tafadhali, tafadhali, tafadhali. Not knowing that they were sabotaging Uganda, all right, but they were also sabotaging Kenya. The efficient handling of cargo in the port and on all the routes to the hinterland is good for the economies of Uganda, economy of Kenya, and the economies of the other hinterland countries. And the more business we do, the better for all of us. So I'm very happy that His Excellency Kenyatta, maybe because of his business background, he has really made a change. Moving from Mombasa to Uganda now, even before the standard gauge railway, has been considerably reduced, depending on the old on the land route. The numbers have been dramatically reduced. In Uganda, we say "Tubatu chali yao." While we were still there celebrating His Excellency Uhuru's intervention on shortening the days for us, for the cargo, he now comes and prosecutes the standard gauge railway. That means the time is going to be shorter. Tomorrow, you have given me the big honor of being the first president to ride on the Kenya Railway, the new railway. This I will put it in my album and show it to all the Ugandans. And I'm told that it will take us just 4 hours to go from here to Nairobi. That's what I've been told. But I know that when the standard gauge railway is finished, it will take 24 hours from here to Kampala. So that means His Excellency and his government have reinforced their support for the hinterland economies, but also, of course, for the economy of Kenya. This is really enlightenment. This is enlightenment. It is what should have been done all the time and what should be done all the time, because there is no other way. There is no other way these economies are going to grow if we don't solve this issue of movement. There is no other way. It is really suicidal to continue behaving as if you are doing a favor to the business people when you help them to move things fast.